The lion. The lion is a huge cat-like animal that lives on the hot plains of Africa. Whether stalking his prey or sleeping in the sun, we are always aware of the strength and energy in this mighty animal. The lion stands about as tall at the shoulder as a dining room table. His shoulders poke up above his back and move as he strides across the plains on his powerful but graceful legs. His limbs are long and carry him in a short but very fast burst of speed as he chases after his dinner. Each leg ends in a huge paw, and hidden within the toes of each paw is a fearfully sharp, curved claw. Unlike the dog, the lion, like all members of the cat family, can detract its claws at will. The lion uses his claws when he attacks his prey, when he fights with other lions, and when he climbs trees. The lion's body is very long and muscular and very flexible. He can bend and twist himself into many positions, leaping up suddenly, bounding through the tall grass, and pouncing on his prey. His neck is short and powerful, carrying his great head. Because the lion often drags his prey, which is often very large, quite some distance, his neck, shoulders, and jaw are immensely strong. The lion's mane is usually darker than his fur, which is generally a tawny brown color with darker spots and splashes on his legs and underside. The tufts of his hair on the lion's legs and at the end of his tail are the same dark color as his mane. The mane frames the lion's wonderfully expressive face. A lion can easily show us if he is angry, puzzled, happy, or content. His large golden eyes, small, furry ears, and squared-off snout assume expressions easily. The lion also lets us and other lions know how he feels through the use of his voice. He makes a low, rumbling sound, something like a purr of a cat, when he is happy, growls fiercely when he is angry, and screams when he is frightened. The lion also will bellow repeatedly for hours at a time, his voice echoing for many miles. We don't know why he does this. Perhaps he is communicating with other animals or other lions. Perhaps it is his way of singing, and he simply enjoys making such loud noises. When the lion opens his massive jaws wide to yawn, we see a fearful sight, a mouth full of long, curved teeth. Four of these teeth help identify the lion as a carnivore. If you look at your teeth in the mirror, you can see your canine teeth, but human beings do not have sharp canines like a lion. The lion's canines can be 4 inches long and are used to tear and bite his prey and to rip off the hunks of meat he eats. The lion, like all carnivores, eats meat. Lions might occasionally eat some birds' eggs if they find them or some fruit, but these are just little treats. Meat is what they need to live. The female lions do most of the hunting and mainly pursue grass-eating animals, such as wildebeest, gazelle, and zebra. Occasionally, they will pursue smaller animals, such as wild pigs or even baboons. If an opportunity presents itself, a group of lions might even hunt a baby elephant. Elephants protect their young with great determination, however, so a hunt would only be successful if there was a very large number of lions and the elephants were isolated or if the mother or baby were injured. The lion is a sociable animal and lives in a family called a pride. One male lion is in charge, and he has several wives. Their young lions and cubs make up the rest of the pride, but when the cubs are old enough, they leave the pride to find their own new family groups. The lions in the pride spend a great deal of time lying in the sun and also grooming. After every meal, each lion thoroughly washes him or herself using their long red tongue and their paws, just like a house cat. The lions also wash each other, licking and nibbling, caring for their pride mates. And of course, the mother lions spend a great deal of time washing their mischievous cubs, who often refuse to stay still long enough to get a proper wash. The lion does not build a home for himself. His pride will live in a particular area, a territory, And the mother lions will use an outcrop of rocks to shelter their cub when they are very young. Sometimes a pride lives most of its life on a rocky hill. Other times, they live mainly around a tree, sleeping under or in it.